I'm curious, do you have faith that pending a conviction of the two human traffickers, the illegal recruiters, there's no conviction as of yet, that yes. President Widodo will be open to grant clemency already? Or do you feel a conviction of the two would have made the chances stronger?
Well, Karen, I forgot to mention, Mary Jane's recruiters have all actually been on a different case, no? Not directly related to Mary Jane, but in a way shows that Mary Jane is also a victim. The two recruiters of Mary Jane have already been sentenced to life in prison. As mentioned
but not
earlier,
related to Mary Jane's case.
Not related, but it's a large-scale illegal recruitment.
But they're behind bars. I think that's what's important.
Yes, they're behind bars. They are behind bars, and I think that even though it's indirectly related to Mary Jane's case, now it involves other Filipino women who were illegally recruited and could have faced the same fate as Mary Jane. I think that the Philippine government can also utilize that. No, so the Philippine government can be more proactive in showing, you know, demonstrating that Mary Jane is indeed a victim of human trafficking.
Okay, all right. So of course you are calling on President Marcos Jr. to give ample time to this. He speaks with President Widodo, and you believe politically it's a good time for Widodo. The chance is now, because you said he isn't running again. And of course, that takes out all the other local issues, right? On how his own constituents would feel. So you believe in terms of furthering diplomacy, this is a good time.
Yes, Karen, definitely a good time. And if I may add that the discussion about Mary Jane doesn't also have to be just about Mary Jane. The discussion between the two presidents today can be in the context of strengthening the efforts of both governments to work together to combat human trafficking, which there are many rising cases now, as we know, even just in the Southeast Asian region. So even in that context, right? How can both governments enhance its efforts to combat human trafficking, to go after the big time traffickers, and enhance protection for the actual victims, and ensuring that the victims have access to swift justice as well. So I think that we talk about Mary Jane, but Mary Jane's case has implications also for our migrant workers, our women who go out of the country, who become vulnerable and become victims to human trafficking. So I think we want to also broaden, and we hope that both presidents see it in that way.
Okay, what can the Philippines do, Joanna, considering you have workers, not just from the Philippines, but from all nationalities, being used as drug mules? Some are really victims, but some are knowingly carrying certain amounts of illegal drugs, right? So there are two kinds. Not all are victims, but what can we do in the Philippines to actually prevent our overseas Filipino workers from even leaving the country carrying any kind of illegal drugs? What can we do? The check in our point. I mean, the airport will ask you, right? Did you pack your bags? Do you knowingly, alam mo la, ikaw lahat ang walang
binigay?
So that's very common. Now, an educated person will take the question seriously and say, yes, okay, these are my bags. Walang naipasa, right? I packed it. But of course, a less educated individual won't know really the weight that comes with these questions. What can we do to help our own workers? Like Mary Jane, could there have been an extra check, right? She didn't know she was carrying 2.6 kilograms of heroin. I mean, that is serious to be carrying in your own luggage.
Yes, definitely, Karen. And I would like to say that, of course.
Okay, I lost you. Go on.
Definitely, the victims who become most vulnerable to human trafficking are those who come from poor backgrounds. No? But we have handled cases and we have launched campaigns in Migrante to call for justice for human trafficking victims who are nurses, who are teachers, and professionals. So wow. Anyone can actually be a victim, right? Of course, it's not.
But I'm curious, you mean to say our victims, yes, who are nurses and teachers, actually, yes, flew and accepted luggage that they did not pack?
Oh, let me clarify, Karen. Yeah,
that's what I want to know.
I meant human trafficking. Human trafficking victims.
Yes. Iba yon. Yes.
Not necessarily.
We're talking about drug mules, because yes, because countries are unforgiving with drug mules. So let's start with that.
Yes. Well, definitely. I think
what can we do?
Well, of course, if we look at just Mary Jane's case, we look at her family's background. We look at her background.
Yeah.
Her father, a longtime farm worker, right? Mother, domestic worker. Her entire family has worked as migrant workers. And so their socioeconomic background, Mary Jane's socioeconomic background, and as well as those who become drug mules, that's what forces them to accept job opportunities, no, abroad, no, and their conditions.
Accepting job opportunities is one thing. Okay, mm-hmm, that's a given. What I'm mm-hmm asking is, from our end, the Philippines, how can mm-hmm we actually prevent Filipinos from leaving with luggage they did not pack? Because that is Mary Jane's defense, right? It was given to her.
Well, Karen, she did not leave the Philippines with that luggage. That luggage was given to her by her traffickers in Malaysia. Because she was promised employment in Malaysia, which is, you know, when she went there, she wasn't carrying drugs at all, nothing, just personal items. It was in Malaysia where her recruiter told her, ay, wala na palang trabaho. The job no longer exists here in Malaysia. You have to go to Indonesia. There's a job there.
Yeah. So she was given the luggage.
And then she was given the luggage. So it did not happen in the Philippines. There's so many, the traffickers are sophisticated. They come up with all these schemes and ways, no? So it did not happen in they bypassed the Philippines, so it happened in Malaysia. The luggage was given to her. She was told that this is an empty, you know, luggage, she can put her belongings, because she did not have a maleta, no, with her to put her stuff. So I think that's one thing I wanted to clarify.
Yeah. Oh, that's very good. But then how could we, I guess, educate our workers, right? Being trafficked is one thing. Looking for a job is another thing. But being given a luggage with heroin is a whole other business, right? So this is where life and death make the difference. So yan ang tanong ko eh, how could we prevent that, Joanna?
Yes, well, I think the Philippine government can strengthen its efforts, its education campaign against human trafficking. I know that the government does have anti-human trafficking, information pamphlets or brochures, or and it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be an interagency effort. Pero kahit mag-post sa website or mag-post sa Facebook, hindi automatic na nababasa, hindi automatic na naiintindihan. So on the ground, no, on the community level, ensure na sa barrio pa lang, sa probinsya pa lang, even the local government up to the national government agencies should coordinate and strengthen its education campaign against trafficking. But also,
kasi ang nangyari kay Mary Jane, tiwala yun eh, di ba? Tiwala,
yes,
yun sa Pilipino
niya.
Rin eh. Pilipino yung nag-abot ng maleta.
Hindi lang Pilipino, Karen. Kamag-anak.
Kaibigan.
Kaibigan, kakilala. So it's a trusted individual sa community nila. So of course that's also an added ano no, hindi ka magdududa. Kasi kung tita mo 'yan o kaibigan mo 'yan, so you wouldn't think na they would harm you, you know, or they would put you in harm's way, no? So yun din, kahit na may duda, may onting duda daw si Mary Jane eh, when she lifted the luggage. Nagtanong siya, sabi niya parang may mabigat, bakit mabigat? Ganun lang daw talaga 'yon, no? Sabi ng recruiter niya, no? Ganyan yung mga bagong luggage. That's how new luggages are. So she inspected it. I think she did her due diligence. Mary Jane did her due diligence to inspect the luggage, and you know, she found nothing.
Nothing, yeah. Kasi yung heroin nakasipit doon sa tabi, right? Wala siya sa mismong pag binuksan mo ang maleta, eh, nasa side.
Oh, yes. Oh. Parang mahusay talaga yung pagkakatago ng drugs.
Oh. Okay, anything you'd like to add, Joanna, before we go?
Yes, well, of course, Karen, we reiterate our call to President Widodo to grant Mary Jane's humanitarian appeal for clemency. And we know that the Indonesian people as well are calling for her release, and she has been in Indonesia in death row for 13 years now. If she continues this year, it will be 14 years. So it's an and also we call on President Marcos that to prioritize Mary Jane's case during his bilateral meeting this morning. So we really expect that he directly places the appeal, and not just through our DFA secretary, to show the president's commitment to protecting Mary Jane and to protecting her life, no? And so we also would like to call on the president that the legal case here in the Philippines matters. Yes. We cannot delay any longer, no, the legal case. It has been 8 years, Karen. Mm-hmm. Mary Jane has been waiting 8 years to testify against her traffickers. What is going on? That is my question. When can she testify? When can she prove that she legally is a victim of human trafficking? And that can also help secure her freedom. And you know, we're very dismayed in a way that the statements made by our leaders, government leaders, that it's in the hands of the Indonesian government. That's incorrect. No, it's not just in the hands of the Indonesian. Yes, the president of Indonesia has the authority and power to grant clemency to Mary Jane. But the Philippine government can also do more, no, be more proactive to prove she is a victim of human trafficking. And we have that opportunity here, the pending legal case against Mary Jane's traffickers here. No more delays in the legal case, because it is an injustice to Mary Jane and an injustice to all the victims of human trafficking who are trying to, you know, trying to prove, no, that they are only victims.
Yeah. All right. So it's our own justice system that's on trial here as well. We have a responsibility as well.
Correct.
Thank you so much for joining me today. And
thank
a blessed new year to you. And kudos to all the work that you do, Joanna.
Thank you so much, Karen.
All right. That's Migrante International Chairperson, Joanna Concepcion. Mm-hmm.